Turning down to weather with 4-1 meteorologist Kaylee Wentz. Kaylee, it is so nice to see that sunshine today after all the rain this weekend.
I know, and I was talking it over with myself, and I decided, you know, it feels so much warmer when temperatures are in the 40s with sunshine
exactly.
than it did yesterday with
difference.
The clouds. Big, big difference. So I hope you are able to enjoy the sun for at least a little while here. Now, Niagara Falls, you can see blue skies, but also a mix of those clouds in there as well, and that's really going to be the case in a lot of areas throughout the entire evening. You'll notice on the satellite and radar that the clouds, at least the thicker clouds, are moving off to the east, but over both western New York and towards the southern tier, you're seeing a little bit more of a clearing. So we are going to continue to watch that because clouds are going to be in control as we move into the evening tonight, and they'll control the temperature, which is important when we're looking at frost and freeze potential for a lot of the crops that are out there. For now, on the satellite and radar, you'll notice the low pressure system still a little too close for comfort. So we left a chance, at least an isolated chance, for a shower in the forecast over the next few hours. But for most of you, it looks like it's going to be a dry evening. For now, it's 49 degrees in Buffalo, 51 over in Warsaw, 54 up in Batavia. Still some upper 40s and low 50s showing up across the southern tier. Wind speeds, however, a bit breezy. So if you do step outside without a jacket, maybe the sunshine tricked you, it's going to feel a little bit cooler than that, down into the low 40s and upper 30s, especially across the southern tier. So just something to make note of, the wind still making an impact in this evening's forecast. Now, here's what you need to know. Those temperatures for a lot of western New York are going to bottom out really in the mid to upper 30s through the overnight. But places like Chautauqua County are going to be much cooler than that, and I'll show you why in just a moment. But here's what you need to know. If you are in Niagara, Erie, over into Orleans, Genesee, and Livingston County, you are under a frost advisory. This begins at 10 p.m. tonight and sticks around till 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. Obviously, if you've got any plants outside, maybe you were eager to get some plants in the ground in your garden, make sure you cover them up or take precaution there because the frost could damage those plants. Now, also a freeze warning in place for Chautauqua County. And the reason it's isolated to Chautauqua County is because there it looks like skies will fully clear out. And without any clouds to act as a blanket overnight, those temperatures really plummet. So here we're actually forecasting those temperatures in the upper 20s for tonight. So very, very chilly. The good news is, besides the chance for that isolated quick shower this evening, going to be remaining dry. For tomorrow morning, we get cool temperatures to start because of how low we're going to be falling overnight. But again, another mainly dry day. Just a few clouds roll in throughout the afternoon and early evening. Overnight clearing out again, so I wouldn't be surprised if we do have a next round of frost advisories and freeze warnings issued for tomorrow evening. But the good news is we're dry for at least the next few days. And I think the next chance for rain really does move in by the weekend. And still, that forecast a little bit shaky at this point. So we'll obviously keep you updated as the models come a little bit closer together for the weekend. For tonight, what you need to know, just that brief isolated shower before partially clearing skies. Wherever the skies are clear, you're going to be feeling the coolest temperatures. So kind of a wide range here on that overnight low. The upper 20s across Chautauqua County, closer to the mid to upper 30s if you move further away from Chautauqua County. Now, very chilly start to the day tomorrow, a mix of some clouds and sunshine, but overall a mainly dry day with highs topping out in the lower 50s. Wind speeds also tomorrow going to be pretty light, so that feels like temperature or wind chill not going to be an issue. Tomorrow evening, once again, we've got the chance for some patchy frost, and that's of course because of those mainly clear skies. Now, in the next half hour of News 4 at 4, we'll take a look at the rest of the 7-day, and we'll talk more about that rain potential for the weekend. Thanks.